everybody. Good evening. Sorry, I'm having a little bit of technical difficulties this evening with my camera and with my internet, but I think we are back in action. Sorry, I'm starting a little bit late. I hope you are all well and having a wonderful evening. Hello, Janelle Sen. Tonight, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to make some meal prep / snack boxes. So you can use these for a meal if you want or for a snack to keep in your car. Hey, Jessica. But first of all, I wanted to give a shout out to my friend Donna tonight because Donna hooked me up with a new holder for my camera that helps keep it a little more stable and steady than it was before. So shout out to Donna for hooking me up with an awesome holder for my camera. Hi. And I also want to give a shout out to my friend Wally Ibarra, who I haven't seen in forever, but has been an awesome supportive fan of my Monday meal prep videos. Hey, Christy. So I want to give a shout out to him, and he had an awesome idea that I will be doing probably in the next month, and that is taking you on a shopping trip with me and really talking about how I plan my food for the week, how I pick recipes, how I make a shopping list, and then how I actually do my shopping when I'm in the store. So be looking for that in about a month. I kind of have some plans already in the works for the next few weeks, and that is kind of a big commitment. I'm going to need some helpers to come to the store with me to do filming and all that kind of stuff. So anyways, I wanted to give a shout out to Wally for the idea, so thank you so much. Hey Brooke, hi Brandy, I hope you guys are having a great evening. So anyways, let's just get right to it. We're going to be making meal boxes or snack boxes. And tonight I have three specific combinations of food that I'm gonna be doing. One is a Tex-Mex box, one is a Mediterranean box, and one we are just calling West Coast Deliciousness box. Okay, hey Daniel. So I'm gonna just go box by box and make one of each. And then I'm also gonna tell you the portion fix containers that go with each of the boxes. Okay? Hi, Drea. So anyways, I hope you guys had a good week. Anybody do anything fun? Go on any cool adventures? Thanks, Jessica, for saying you go to the store with me. That would be awesome. Hey, Mona. This weekend, I got to go camping and celebrate Feast of Booths with my family and my church family, and we just had a wonderful time laughing and being together and celebrating and remembering wonderful things and wonderful blessings. So, anyways, that's what I did with my weekend, and then I came back and headed to school, and it was a pretty darn good Monday back with the kids, so I hope you all had great weekends as well with your family. That was full of adventure, full of joy, and definitely full of some rest. Hey, Emily. All right, let's jump into the Tex-Mex box. Okay, this box is going to have 8 corn chips or gluten-free crackers. It's going to have a 1/2 cup of pico de gallo salsa. It's going to have a 1/2 cup of sliced red bell pepper, 1 ounce of jack cheese or pepper jack cheese, and 1 cup of mango. I love the idea of these boxes, and I've honestly never gone to the extreme to make a box of all these varieties of things, but I don't know about you guys, but car time is really tough for me because it's usually after school, I'm hungry, I want like a good big snack, AKA I want dinner. But I don't want to stop, so I'd rather have some good options for myself in my car. So let's start out with the Tex-Mex box. And I'm just using, you can't really tell, this container has 3 sections in it. I'm using some different portion containers I had at my house. This one has two. This is kind of like a fancy bento box that goes together. And then I just have some regular old plastic rectangular meal prep boxes. So I'm just gonna kind of stuff in what I can stuff in and make it work with what I have. So first thing is those 8 corn chips. Okay, these are organic ones that I bought in the health food section at Fred Meyer's. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. My suggestion to you with these is to put them in their own separate container and don't allow anything else to touch it, so that way it will still stay crisp. If you put cheese next to it or a fruit or veggie that's wet, it's gonna soak up that liquid and turn soggy. Hey, Inga. Hi, Eichelberry, good to see you on here. So we have our 8 corn chips. I'm gonna do a half a cup of the pico de gallo in one of the other containers. Okay, so it's just like that so far. A half a cup of red bell pepper. I'm gonna step over here for a second. And for me, that's approximately 6 slices. So I'm gonna grab 6 slices of red bell pepper and put that in there. Okay, so that's going in my kind of bigger section. Then I'm also gonna put some cheese in that section. This is approximately 1 ounce of cheese that I just sliced up. I'm gonna lay that next to my bell pepper. And then it calls for 1 cup of mango, which is kind of hard to measure perfectly because I kept that sliced as well. But I'm going to do my best kind of measuring it. That's 1 cup right there. And I'm gonna lay that next to the cheese and the bell pepper. So it's gonna help it stay a little bit moist. I might be able to taste a little bit of that mango on my cheese, but I actually don't think I'm gonna mind that at all. So that is my first Tex-Mex box. We have our 8 corn chips or gluten-free crackers, 1/2 cup of pico de gallo, 1/2 cup of red bell pepper, which is about 6 strips for me. Hey, Jason. 1 ounce of jack cheese, and 1 cup of mango. So there is one of my meal box / snack boxes. Again, whatever sounds good for you, if it's a snack or if it is for a whole meal, that's great as well. For portion fixed containers, this is gonna be 1 purple. Remember, purple is your fruit. It's gonna be 1 blue, 1 green, and 1 yellow. Set that to the side. So again, 1 purple for fruit, 1 blue for healthy fats, 1 green for your veggies, and 1 yellow for our carbs, which we're calling our chips tonight. Okay, so that was our Tex-Mex box. The next one I'm gonna try is the Mediterranean box. This one has 1/4 cup of my absolute favorite hummus that you can get at Fred Meyer's. It's called King's Harvest Hummus, and it is a Portland company. I'm just blanking. I thought I pulled it out. Maybe I didn't pull it out yet. King's Harvest Hummus. My favorite flavor is the roasted garlic. There we go. Roasted garlic hummus. So, so tasty. It's usually in the health food section at Fred Meyer. So we're gonna start out with some King's Harvest hummus, 1 cup of cherry tomatoes, 10 medium olives, which I love, love, love deli olives, 1 cup of grapes, and either 2 mini pitas or 8 gluten-free crackers. And tonight I decided to go with the gluten-free crackers because I was having a hard time finding mini pitas. Okay, so let's start putting together our Mediterranean box. Okay, the first thing is going to be the quarter cup of hummus. And I'm actually gonna use a tiny container that I have and just put it at the bottom of my larger purple container with a lid on it, because again, those moist ingredients don't want to mix with your dry ingredients like crackers, otherwise they're gonna get soggy, okay? So a quarter cup is approximately 2 tablespoons. I'm gonna put 2 tablespoons in my blue container. I'm gonna lick my spoon because it's that good. I'm gonna put my lid in my hummus container, pop that in my big purple container. I'm gonna add a cup of cherry tomatoes, and I've got these cherub little tomatoes that are sweet and fantastically delicious. And a cup of these is about 12, 14 of these little guys. So a cup of cherry tomatoes. And I'm actually going to put those on top of that blue container of hummus in here. I'm kind of rolling around now. Because the other thing that I'm gonna mix with those cherry tomatoes that I actually feel totally good about is grapes, okay? I'm gonna mix a cup of grapes that I have right over here. And these are nice, firm, sweet, delicious grapes that I'm just gonna mix in with the cherry tomatoes because they really have the same consistency, so they shouldn't do anything to harm each other or change the flavor or change the texture or anything like that, okay? So underneath we have our hummus, then we have the cherry tomatoes and the grapes on top of that. Next ingredient is gonna be our olives. So I'm gonna use another one of my little tiny blue plastic containers to put olives in. These are my favorite snack. Delicious salty deli olives. I love the garlic stuffed green ones. So good. Or the Kalamatas. So I'm gonna pull 10 out. I'm gonna do 5 of each. Wally. Hey, Wally. All right, so I have 10 olives. I'm gonna put another lid on there. And the last thing to pop in is my gluten-free crackers. Garlic and olives are my favorite too, Drea. So delicious. So I'm gonna pop those olives inside of there and add 8 gluten-free crackers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In here. Actually, this isn't gonna fit. So let me adjust. Let's see if I take the lid off. Maybe it'll fit like that. No. Let's see. Maybe if I just dump them into the lid and balance them on top of the crackers, that might work. This could be a trouble. You know what I can do? I can try a baggie. Let's try a baggie. See, people, this is very real life. It doesn't work the first time all the time. Emily says, I'm not a fan of tomatoes. What else do you recommend? Great question, Emily. I think since we have hummus in there, carrots would be an awesome option, or cucumbers would be really great too if you like cucumbers. So maybe try carrots or cucumbers. That would be cool. So I just put my olives in a baggie and I'm just gonna fit those and put them on top of my crackers and voila, whoopsies. Everything fits in there like a little dream. And then I can put my top on. And I'm ready to go, I got another one. So that was the Mediterranean box. And now we are going to make the Northwest box. Thanks, Em. My computer's slowing down. All right, so in, or not the Northwest, the West Coast box. And P.S., I got all of these ideas for these boxes on Pinterest, but honestly, what are good things that you like? Put them in a box. If they're healthy, awesome. Pinterest has some amazing ideas, okay? Before we move on to the next one, I wanted to tell you the portion fix containers for the Mediterranean box is gonna be one yellow for the crackers, one purple for the grapes, two blues because we're having hummus and we're having the olives, and then one green for our cherry tomatoes, which is our veggie. So I hope that one looks tasty to you too. I think that'll be a fun one. So now we're gonna move on to our West Coast box. And I'm gonna try to make that one in this fun little bento box container. As long as it fits my clementine, I think we're good to go. So the West Coast box, again, is gonna have hummus, okay? So I think I'm going to use this guy for my hummus. So I'm gonna measure out 2 tablespoons of hummus and stick it in this blue container. And that's gonna go at the bottom of my box. I'm gonna need 8 gluten-free crackers, so I'm gonna just add those right on top. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, Lainey. I also need 1 cup of cucumbers. So for that one, I'm gonna put my cucumbers in the baggie again. Because that is a really nice option to keep your food separate and not have it leak. And that is 1 cup. Cucumbers. Sorry guys, I don't have enough counter space. Cut the cucumbers into my baggie. And I'm gonna put this one, cucumbers with the clementine. Okay, kind of cute, right? And then I'm gonna put, instead of feta, I'm going to actually put a little bit of jack cheese. So I'm going to grab my jack cheese and I'm going to add it to the box that has the cucumbers and clementine in it. So again, we have crackers and hummus, and on top of that is going to go a clementine, 1 cup of cucumbers, and 1 ounce of jack cheese. I'm gonna screw this on top. Kinda cute, huh? And it has a little lid and a little handle that goes on top. I love little container stuff, it's really fun. Cute little pail to keep in the fridge and then pull out and put in your car when you want a nice little snack. So that is our West Coast box. The portion fix containers for that is 1 purple for your fruit, your clementine, 1 yellow for your crackers, 2 blues for your cheese and your hummus, and then 1 green for your cucumbers. So that is our third box. We made the Tex-Mex, the Mediterranean, and the West Coast box. So I'm actually gonna make 2 more of these, and these are gonna be my lunches for the week. And then any extra ingredients that I have, I will package those up and just keep them as snacks, because I'm really trying to be better about using everything that I have so that it doesn't go to waste. And that's hard when you're using fresh stuff, it goes bad. So you're gonna waste food more if you don't eat it. So I would encourage you to really think about what you want to eat for the week and how you can use it in multiple meals So that you don't have a bunch of random leftovers that are gonna go bad because they don't get eaten. So those are our three boxes for the week. I hope that you try those. And again, think about anything that you enjoy. Think about fruits and veggies that you enjoy. Think about healthy dips. You could make that ranch dip with the chicken breast that I made months ago. You could do the hummus. Think about a good healthy fat like the feta or a little bit of cheese. And olives, which that olive oil is a nice, good, healthy fat. Think about a little bit of carb that you can mix in there that you enjoy. I love, love, love the Nut Thins. Nut Thins are the gluten-free crackers that I use, and they're made primarily from almonds. So check those out in the natural section at Fred Meyer's too. They are delicious. And again, if you're gonna try hummus and maybe you've never actually been a hummus fan, King's Harvest hummus is the best. It tastes amazing and is made with garbanzo beans, sesame seeds, a blend of canola and olive oil, garlic, lemon juice, some spices, and salt. And it is the best, the absolute best, hands down. So just think of things that you enjoy. Think about how you can put them together. Think about how you can make it convenient. And if it's convenient and healthy and stuff that you like, you're actually gonna eat it. I know I like to eat stuff that tastes good, so that has to be a huge part of the equation for me. So give these boxes a try, and I hope that you really like them, and I would love to hear how you do like them. And again, I would love for any of your ideas for meals that you'd like to see in the future, or ideas that you have, or things that you need help and support with. And I would be so happy to do a video on those or do some research and help you while you're on your journey to finding great health and great wellness. Just wanted to let you guys know I have a couple of challenge groups coming up. One of them is the 3-day Shakeology and Clean Eating Cleanse. That's September 18th, 19th, and 20th. 3 days, 3 shakes every day, and then real food in between. We're eating primarily vegetables and fruit. We're eating a little bit of lean meat and a little bit of low-fat cheese. So if you are interested in all, add a cleanse that's just gonna help move through some of those yucky toxins and clean out your system a little bit, but you still want to be able to eat some real food and make it realistic for your life, because realistic is going to be more sustainable, please hit me up and I would be happy to add you to that group. If you already have Shakeology or another shake that you really like, you can still join the group. And if you don't have Shakeology and you've been wanting to give it a try, this is the perfect opportunity for you to do that. So just send me a message or reach out and I would be happy to share that info with you. Excuse me. And then in October, we're going to be doing Clean Week, October 9th through the 15th. And that's just a great way to transition into an eating and fitness program if you've been kind of out of that for a while. And just kind of help you slowly get back into the mode of working out and eating healthy and trying again to make it a realistic piece of your life, because it has to be realistic for it to be sustainable. Are you gonna mess up and eat junk? Yes. Are you gonna be tired and not want to do a workout some days? Yes. But are you gonna be able to get back in there the next day? Are you gonna be able to make good choices the next time? Are you gonna be able to get yourself up and do a workout the next day? That's what it is. Make it realistic, make it sustainable, and if you need accountability, that's what I'm here for. If you need friends to be a part of that with you, friends are a fantastic support system as you're moving through this journey. Tomorrow morning at 5, I'll be up with one of my roommates doing a workout. So bring your friends along. It's good for everybody. Okay? So that's about it, you guys. I hope that you have a fantastic week. I'm gonna look here. I forgot to write down what I have coming up next. I wanted to share some of my recipes that we are going to be making for the next few weeks. Thank you for that love, Brandy. So today is September 11th. On the 18th, we are going to be making, mug cakes. Okay, so little individual treats. They are cake-like inside of a mug that you can make in the microwave that are healthy, and they're totally going to give you that sugar fix if you are having a craving for something baked or sweet or cake-like, and this is a really healthy option for that, okay? So next week, we're gonna be doing mug cakes. The week after that, on September 25th, we are gonna be doing crock pot, because hopefully by then the weather's gonna be changing a little bit more. It's gonna feel more like fall. We're gonna want some yummy soups to eat that are warm when it's cold outside. So we're gonna be making a crock pot meal. And then on October 2nd, which will be that following Monday, that is my day that I am going to be working to plan a grocery shopping video, okay? So we're gonna talk about figuring out how you wanna eat, like what style of eating. Are you gonna eat Whole30? Are you gonna eat paleo? Are you just gonna eat balanced with some carbs? Are you a low carb person? What's your style of eating that you wanna do? Then we're gonna look up some recipes or some different things that fit with that style of eating. Then we're gonna create a list of all the ingredients that we need to cook for those things. And then we'll go shopping and pick some of them up. And then you can make all of your delicious meals for the week with that stuff. That is usually how I plan and shop for the week. Life is life and life is crazy, so it doesn't happen every week, but a majority of the time, that is what I am aiming to do. And before I do my videos with you guys on Mondays, that's when I do a lot of cooking and prepping for my week. One, so that I can show you what I made, and two, so that I'm set up for success during the week. So that when I go to work, I have lots of good snacks, lots of lunch stuff. When I get up and I'm driving to work, I have my shakes in the car. Sometimes I make additional breakfast stuff to eat like around 9:30 or 10, like the eggs in the jar that we did last week. And then I gotta have some snacks. Because I really enjoy eating and I need snacks after my day. I don't sit down very much, and so I need some fuel. And then sometimes dinners. Sometimes I eat dinner out during the week. Other times I'm at home, so I think about what I'm gonna eat for my dinners too. So I'd be happy to show you a little bit of what I do to help you on that portion of your journey. So I think that is it for tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope that you are gonna steal some of these ideas and implement them into your life. And I really hope that if you're interested in any of this, want to learn more, need a sounding board, just need some support, that you will be sure and let me know, because I'm happy to do that for you, and happy to share my journey with you. I hope that you have a great, great evening and a great rest of your week, and I will see you soon. Good night.